understand what I'm saying? This Babylon was richer, 100 times richer than Australia. Sodom and Gomorrah was 1 million times richer than Australia. By the rivers of Babylon. Read it, sir.
There we sat down.
We sat down.
Yea, we wept.
We wept.
When we remembered Zion.
When we remembered, oh, Makoria, Makosh. When we remembered that we are Christians, what are we doing in strange land? When we remembered that we are faithful servants of God. When we remembered that God has chosen us for miracle. God has chosen us for supernatural encounter. He said, we wept. Some of us, even when we make mistakes and fall into sin, we don't even, it doesn't pain us. Continue.
We hang our harps upon the willows in the midst thereof.
They said they folded their drum, musical instrument, because they know these uncircumcised Philistines, these sinners will come. Continue.
For there are they that carried us away captive, required of us a song.
They wanted us to sing the love song. Continue.
And they that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion.
They want us to sing. It's happening here. It's happening. I've been with my people, Nigerian people. They were drinking beer, you know. They finished the first bottle, the second bottle. And they were not telling me, Idika, Pastor Idika, you know, we that are born again. After taking three bottles of beer. We that are born again, you know, we came to this nation. You see how prosperous we are. Spirit of backwards. Spirit of backwards, he has possessed you. Drunk, and you are sitting before me. I say, God, this is why you brought me here. I will intimidate these people with faithfulness towards you. I will intimidate them. And I will get them back for you. So before we came, when we called pastors, come out. More than 200 people come out in a meeting. But I'm telling you as of today, if I am in a meeting where 300 people are, and there are formerly people that claim to be pastors, nobody comes out. I might be the one that comes out. Because they've seen for 10 years, they have seen that this man, since he came, one day, he has never sang the Lord's song in a strange land. Nothing strange has ever gotten me. Maybe by now we were expecting Pastor Joseph would have had a hearing here. I would have had tattoo, you know, to show big ball, black ball. I have not visited one pub in Australia. No lady in Australia. If any lady come and say that I've ever come to her, I say, oh baby, you are cootie, cootie, cootie. I'll stop preaching. I'll resign as a pastor. If any lady in Malaysia or Australia, that I lived in Malaysia 7 years, and I've lived here 9 years, if any lady come out, I'm on the media, I'm on Facebook, if anybody come out and say, I have ever come as a kind of infatuation or admiration, maybe I would have tried if I had seen that Jinko woman that my boy, that God, that my boy. Or that Jimmy's girlfriend. I might have fallen. The church, I'm telling you, I can't sing the Lord's song in a strange land. So stop singing the Lord's song. And look at what God says in verse 5. Can you read it? 5 or 6. And say, because of this, your faithfulness, supernatural encounter. If supernatural encounter doesn't happen, let this happen. Read it. 5. I say,
if I forget thee.
If I forget you.
Oh, Jerusalem.
Oh, my son.
Let my right hand forget her coming.
Continue.
If I do not remember thee, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth.
Number 3. Go to Daniel chapter 6, 22 and 23.
6?
Yeah. Daniel chapter 6, verse 22. That's the fourth one. I mean the third one. The first one is wisdom. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The second one is never allow strange person, strange land, strange thing, strange anything change you. Rather change them. Don't allow them to defy you. Number three, Daniel chapter 6, verse 22, read.
My God has sent his angel.
This supernatural encounter that you are now hearing my testimony happened because God sent his angel.
He has shut the lion's mouth.
Uh-huh.
That they have not hurt me.
Yeah.
For as much as before him, innocence was found in me.
I have an innocent, excellent spirit. Number three. Excellent spirit. Five platforms for supernatural encounter. Number one is wisdom, which starts with the fear of the Lord. Number two, don't allow. How do I say it? One of the demons, he kind of that, you know, God has helped me to fight very well in a strange land, is technology, computer, phone. I love electronics so much. I've not seen all those things. But do you know I control them? I say, if I can't control them, I control what I do with it. I control my time with them. I control everything. So that my children will see me in my office when I'm doing this. Isn't that you have many devices? How do you handle all these things? I say, you'll be greater than me. And when you're greater than me, you will understand. You will not understand now. Because there are things you can do with Mac operating system you can't do with Android. There are things you can do with Android, you can't do with Apple. So when you have the two operating systems, it helps. And there are other things. And I'm very technical in all these things. But because I don't want strange land to stop me. Number three, Daniel said, excellent spirit, before you, O God, I have not sinned against you. Before you, O God, I have not abused your flock. Before you, O God, I have honored my wife. Before you, O God, I have honored my children. Before you, O God, I have not abused your church, the ministry you handed over. I am innocent. I am innocent, Lord. Do you really know there is a judge? A judge you can never escape. On the last day, and they give us number four, the fourth one, 23.
Then was the king exceedingly glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel.
No, you didn't dare say, "Well, if you miss something." Before the Lord, I was found innocent. There was another one, the next one.
And also before thee, O king.
And before you, O king.
Have I done no hurt?
You know, there was a guy that was sentenced today, life imprisonment. How many of us saw it?
Yeah,
on news.
The guy that
he killed people. Did you hear what the guy said the last time before this final day?
Was something speaking to him?
He said he's doing the righteous thing. He knows what he's doing, you know. If God said it, you all are. You will say they don't know God. He knows God. He knows that. God is saying, if you want supernatural encounter to happen in your life, pray for the government. Pray for the authority. Bless the authority. For in their peace, you shall have peace. Don't destroy what they have. Are you getting it? So Daniel said, before Jehovah, I am innocent. And before you, O great king, I have lived in Australia 9 years. I'm not owing any bank. I have not cheated anyone. I have not abused their women. I have not done anything wrong. Go and check. Check my record. Thank God Australia is a police nation, which if you go to police, you get every information. I have not. Oh, check my record. Before God that I preach, before the God that brought me to Australia, and before you, Scott Morrison, and your government, even the opposition party, I have not disobeyed the law of the land. I have kept your law. That's the fourth one. Pray for any nation, for India peace. Pray for the peace of that nation. Look at Daniel. Daniel said, you know it. I've been worshiping my God. All I know is worshiping my God. Why did they put me into prison? Because I opened my window and prayed to my God. And they brought me to this prison. And you know, O king, you are the king of the land. Check my record. Have I committed any sin? Police check, criminal check. Boom. Oh, your name is clear. So this guy killed people and he's claiming that he doesn't know what to do. I wonder. Well, he's now locked up in a place. Every right has been removed from him. He will only eat when the prison warders give him food. But before he was free, now he's no more free. No responsibility any longer. He's gone back to becoming a child now. So in that prison now, he's a child. Anything, he doesn't have right of his own again. That will happen. And that is why the Bible says, spread the rod, and what, spoil the child. You see? So now he's a child now, they are flogging him. Am I making sense? And what's the fifth one? Hosea chapter 13, verse 12 and 13. Five platforms for supernatural intervention. Yes. Are you there, Rick? Hosea 13, 12 and 13. The iniquity.
The iniquity of Ephraim is bound up, his sins is hid. The sorrows of a travailing woman shall come upon him. He is an unwise son, for he should not stay long in the place of breaking forth.
Now, Ephraim has committed a lot of sins, made a lot of mistakes. But the time has come for God to remove everything. But his circumcision is painful. God was about to remove everything. Remove every mistake he has made. And Ephraim lacked the spirit of waiting. He said the pain of a woman in childbirth came upon him. But Ephraim is an unwise son. So the fifth one is waiting. Read Isaiah chapter 64, verse 4.
For since the beginning of the world,
yes,
men have not heard,
yes,
nor perceived the ear, by the ear, neither have the eye seen, O God, beside thee, what he had prepared for him that waited for him.
You see, the world have not seen, the eyes have not seen, they've not heard what God has prepared for those that wait upon him. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 27. Verse 17 and 18. Can you read it? Iron sharpened iron.
Okay.
Yes. Proverbs 27. 17 and 18. Yes.
Iron sharpened iron.
Uh-huh.
So a man sharpened the countenance of his friend.
Yes.
Whoso keepeth the faith.
If you keep the faith, he's talking about patience. He that waiteth upon his master. Continue.
The fig tree shall eat the fruit thereof.
Mm.
So he that waiteth on his master shall be honored.
Waiting. Waiting brings honor. Let's synchronize it. The fear of the Lord, number one. If you have the fear of the Lord, that's the beginning of wisdom. Number two, a lot of things will happen in your life. Strange things will happen. Don't allow those strange things to change you. Rather, change those strange things. Number three, make sure that you have an excellent spirit before God. And also make sure in the land where you are, you have a good testimony. I have, anytime, you know, I'm doing something special and I try to bring in CGMI Malaysia, the first thing Australia will ask me is to get certificate of good conduct from Malaysia. And anytime I apply for it, bam, within 1 month, they send it to me. Clean. This guy has no advance. Make sure you are clean. I lived in Malaysia. It wasn't easy. But look at the government say, this guy had no, there's nothing harassing, there's nothing, anything evil he did. Certificate of good conduct. Here in Australia, Staffy, you know, when I came in, I printed complimentary card, very hand, beautiful complimentary card. When I give it to them, they say, what's the spelling there? Idika, Idika. And before my face, they type in the computer. And that time, I didn't have much pages on Google. I said, wow, their system is different. Call card is not even important. Just spell your name very well for them. What's your name, Idika? How do you spell it? How do you spell it? A-I-D-I, I for India, D for Delta, I for India, K for Kilo, A for Alpha. They type it, oh, is that you? Hey. That was when I stopped complimentary card. If you don't have this good record, your life should be a light. I have a celestial spirit, my good record with God. I don't really want to keep my record with God. But look at my lifestyle in this nation. And finally, wait. Ephraim lost it. Remember the story of Ephraim. Because he doesn't have that spirit to wait. At the beginning, his father promoted him above Manasseh. Manasseh was the first son. He was the second son. But Jacob promoted him and said, you shall be greater than Manasseh. Manasseh didn't struggle with him. In Psalms, there was battle. Ephraim ran away. The Bible says, after God has equipped him. 78 verse 9. Can we read Psalms? Yes. Yeah.
The children of Ephraim, being armed and carrying bows, turned back in a day of battle.
You see now? They ran away. In Hosea, the Bible says, when I would have blessed Ephraim, his sin was discovered. Read it, Hosea chapter 7, verse 1 and 2. Hosea chapter 7.
When I would have healed Israel.
Another version called it Ephraim. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Then the iniquity of Ephraim was discovered.
Then the iniquity, I wanted to bless Israel. Iniquity of Ephraim. What was iniquity? He was, you know, to wait. You need to have a fighting spirit. The spirit of waiting is also the spirit of fighting. Because you fight to remain. Because the Bible says in something in Malachi chapter 3 verse 6. Can you read it? Malachi, patient, about patient. God talking about his own patient. He defined his own patient. In Malachi chapter 3 verse 6. Can you read it? I am the Lord.
For I am the Lord.
I change it now.
I change not.
I remain patient, waiting. And that is why the children of Israel are not consumed. Ephraim couldn't wait. Ephraim will see battle and run away. Ephraim couldn't wait for God's victory. Ephraim couldn't wait for God's supernatural intervention. In Hosea chapter 7, and God gave him the last chance. In Hosea chapter 13, where we're there, he said, the iniquity of Ephraim has piled up. Now I'm going to remove it, but he needs to wait for me to do that. And when God started removing it, the Bible says, the pain of a woman in childbirth came upon Ephraim. Ephraim said, Oga, I don't want it. I don't want it. And he moved God's hand and ran away. And do you know what happened in Revelation? Ephraim was brought in by his father. He wasn't qualified to be among the 12 children of Israel. He wasn't qualified. His father sneaked him in. But do you know what happened in Revelation? God removed him. Ephraim is not among the 12 tribes of Israel. He was removed. He lost it all. The Manasseh that was not chosen took his place. That will never be your question. So in this season of supernatural platform, you will fear God. And no strange thing will ever defy you. Your record with God shall be excellent. And your record with the commission or the land where God has blessed you shall also be excellent. And in time of waiting, the Lord shall give you the strength. You shall wait until your miracle comes. Church, let's stand up. Shabbatagada. Are you ready to pray? Shabbatagada. Ma profu tuli baba. Ube iba kula. Kutere boko ya. I live with a woman, my mother. A woman every midnight, she sings it. Oh, you need to hear her voice. Very beautiful voice. She will sing it every midnight. Every midnight. And we saw the way she prayed and fast. And when she see like juju, other people go to cross several rivers and go and do juju and come. She will just use her hand, the left hand, and throw it away. I say, what kind of woman? I need that power.